starting with a fun session, so you will have a good experience for shopping later. And now we are talking about, in this session, we are going to talking about standard operating procedures. I think most of you are familiar with SOP, not only for the study, but also for your daily practice in your institution, we have SOP. But let's see whether the SOP that we already had previously is fulfilling the criteria of what the GCP mentioned. So at the end of this session, we hope that you are not only understand what the definition of SOP. I will not going to tell you what the definition of SOP, but you will learn by this session that SOP is blah blah blah. But you will also understand why and when SOP are needed, SOP and how to use them, and also in the last, what is a criteria of a good SOP. Okay, let's start with this case study. So there was a study on malaria which aimed to compare the diagnostic value of rapid diagnostic tests compared the conventional microscopic test for detecting malaria. Contain malaria, so it is positive or not. And then they were also asked to evaluate or to determine the percentage of red blood cells infected by malaria. In this study, they do not have SOP, and even no SOP training was provided. And then once upon time, the reviewer come to the site to evaluate the study, and the reviewer discussed with these two lab assistants about how they read the slide. And this is the conclusion of the reviewer about how the two assistants reading the blood smear. So I'd like you to discuss with your friends. I think this is five. It's already in a group, but five, and then four, and then four, and this one. How many participants do we have? 18. So divided into four. Four, four, five, five. And the rest is five. Oh, you are not the participant, sorry. That's too many. One, two, three, four, five. And this is one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So please move here, Bu Sudarwanti and Pak Dani, move to this side. And this is the group one, two, and three, and four. Please discuss with your friends in the small group and then comment about the study. I will give you 2 minutes for discussion.
Thank you. According to our discussion, we find here that this study, there is no SOP, standard operating procedure, and because of that, we find here that there is a difference between a first assistant and the second assistant from how to examine it and how to interpret it, and how about to keep the data, especially about the original paper with counts. So we conclude that every study must have a special SOP to guarantee the result of the research.
Okay, thank you. So you mentioned that there are two different way for measurement, for reading, for keeping the data. Okay, yeah. And the next group, please mention other things that already been mentioned by the previous one. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I think we already agree with the group number one, but the things come first, that there are two ways, very different ways of how the assistant one and assistant two works. And I think to reduce the inter-observer and intra-observer bias, we should make SOP, yeah, to reduce the bias and to make the research result more proper, I think.
Okay, the next group.
Thank you. According to our discussion, yes, SOP is lacking here. Another thing is that there is no procedure for data management or record keeping, because this is difference. One is destroy, another is keep. So there must be include the data record or data management.
Okay. And the last one, do you have any other comment? Please. Yeah.
Basically, there is no standard operating procedure in this. So the two assistants did the assessment differently. So this will give different results, and the study will not be.
Okay. Valid. Which one do you think the better one? Assistant one or assistant two?
Assistant two.
Assistant two. And your group, assistant two, you?
Assistant two, but I think distilled water may be better if it used by assistant two.
Okay, so assistant one, assistant two. Well, use your microphone.
Maybe we can SOP with the expert.
So because if I you are asked which one is better,
yeah,
you can't tell.
I don't know exactly what's
yeah.
better.
Actually, we cannot assess which one is better here because yeah. the study doesn't have the SOP. Okay, so we cannot just judge this one by this criteria. So this is a big problem for a study. And as a researcher, you all have a feeling that if we do a study like this, so what kind of data that will be generated by this study? As you remember, that one of the GCP principle is to generate the valid data of clinical trial. So this is, by in this case, so we are all agree that SOP is very important and needed in study. And the next question is why? Why do we need the SOP? Okay, please discuss. At least we will have four reasons for that. Okay, 2 minutes again. So each group should mention one reason that was different from the other. Yeah. Nice bias. Good.
For standardized methodology.
To standardize the methodology.
Yeah.
Good. Next. Hello. Yeah.
I think to avoid false positive or false negative.
To avoid false positive and false negative. Okay, yeah.
To limit variability between observers and the expected
the
outcomes.
Same thing with the standardized. Anything else?
Safety.
For the safety reason?
Yeah, I think that's to give a guarantee safety for the subject and safety for the investigators.
Good. Next. You still have five here? Yeah? No?
To make the results comparable between different investigators who
okay,
are involved.
Okay, good. Next. What else? Come.
For a reconstruction of the same study, if someone wants to take the study, so that if there is a standard procedure, they can retake the study.
They can repeat the study. Yeah. So it's still about the standardized, yeah?
Same.
Okay, next.
Maybe for legal aspect, if we do the procedure with the proper SOP, so.
The legal aspect.
Yes.
It's not really actually, but it's good. Yeah. One more.
Data validity.
Data validity. Okay, Bu Anis, you want to add? No. Okay. Yeah. So Actually, this is some of the reasons. So you already mentioned some. So here is the consistency, the uniformity is about the standardization of the method. So everybody who will do this procedure will have the same protocol on the same step, and then the result we expected the same. And this is also if in case there is a personal turnover, so the one who changes this staff, they will also do the similar thing in the same way. With the SOP, our study will be also more efficient because the procedure has been determined, and then everything has been mentioned. And then it is also for proficiency for the staff, and it is important for the tool for the training before the study is started. And then the last one is it is related to the audit trail. So we have to be transparent about whatever the procedure that we do in the study. When the reviewer come to our site and review about the result of our study, and we are asked how come or how is the data come from, so we can show them that we collect the data properly. Okay, so in which procedure that we need SOP? What do you think? Which procedure in the study that need SOP? Speak up, please. Clinical? Yeah, in clinical trials, in which procedure? In clinical trials, we have many procedures.
Methodology.
Methodology. And data collection, do you mean? Yeah. What else?
For treatment
outcome measurement, yeah, that's the data collection, the same.
Case measurement tool.
Measurement tool, data collection, what else? So I think this is the time that you have to, you will have a different view about the SOP. So SOP is needed when you think that the procedure is routinely done, and if the procedure is performed inconsistently, this will affect the result of the study, the quality of the study, the safety of the study. So it is not only about data collection. So maybe in our mind, we still think that SOP is like a protocol, like an algorithm, that how we collect the data. But SOP should be there. When we have, we will have informed consent, we have to have SOP, how to do informed consent. So whoever will do the informed consent, they will do in the same way. Similarly, with the interaction of the ethics committee that has been explained by Bu Nina in the morning, there are many things deal with ethics committee. Maybe sometimes we need to do amendment, so there should be also an SOP. And the other things that important, how should we report the severe adverse event, and also the management of investigational medicinal product, and also the trial master files, how should we manage the data here? There should be an SOP. So in clinical trial, as an investigator, we not only deal with collecting the data, but also from the beginning of the study, we have to be deal with the GCP, and there should be an SOP. There are some other procedures that need SOP, but there is no strict rule how many SOP that a study should have. This should be discussed among the investigators and also maybe from the sponsor, and you will decide which one should be have SOP. But I give you like what is it, idea about which procedure for the SOP. Okay. And what is and how is a good SOP? So a good SOP should have this element. So it has to mention about what has to be done, who has to do what, how has it to be done, and when has it to be done, and where has it to be done. So it should contain these things. And let's start to an exercise about SOP. You already be given a color paper, okay? And just take your pencil. I have instruction here, and please follow the instruction, and let's see how is the result. Oh, use pen, because you will see the, use pen, okay. Okay, ready? Yeah. Please draw three triangles. If you look at your neighbors, you will fail in this course. No. Oh, it's whatever. Okay, already? No question. Just do it. And then draw two small circles. Yeah, done? And now draw one big circle. Okay. And then draw six straight lines. Okay, and draw C on its side.
English alphabet C.
Kita kan nomor 6 atau nomor 5 tok ya lah. Udah ya nomor aja ya. Okay. Finish. And now saw the result. What do you have, Pak Kem? Oh, good. There's a river, and you have kids. And then, okay. She also have something beautiful as well. I think we have door prize here. We have prize iPhone 7. Where is the iPhone 7? And then, oh, Bu Adit, you also have more or less. And let's see. Is it yours? Or this one? Actually, we ask you to draw this picture. Okay, so do you know where's the problem? Why you didn't cannot draw this picture? Why? What you think?
We have no standard SOP, no instruction.
That's the SOP. That's the SOP. The previous one. This is the SOP. We have the SOP. We already have the SOP.
But
okay.
There is no, it has direction, but it has no standardized direction. So everyone follow like that, to a small circle within the big circle, not like that.
Okay, so, and the other word, what do you call it? You need what?
Detail.
You need detail, yeah. Okay. And what else?
There is a specific guideline here, that is the that he mentioned that the two small circle between in a big circle and three straight line on a side, mm-hmm. And the C is
Where
so
is
there
the
is
B?
A specific okay. guideline is here.
Okay, so this is the example of a bad SOP. So we already have SOP, but what we need is not only SOP but a good SOP. A good SOP should have something like this. Please, how if we have this instruction so it's more clear? Yeah, so draw three triangles representing the ears and nose, draw two small circles, and blah, blah, blah. So it's more clear. So an SOP should be simple and easy to follow. It should be also detailed, and also it has content and language that is understandable. It also should be clear and coherent and complete. So this is the criteria of a good SOP. I think by doing that exercise, so you know then if you make SOP that is not fulfilling this criteria, so the result will be very different. So we have 18 investigators or 18 staff to do examination, and the data that we gather for you all is not valid. Okay? Well, and now who should write the SOP? Ideally, the one who should write the SOP is someone who performed that procedure. Okay, but sometimes, for example, for the lab technicians, they cannot do that, maybe in the lab supervisor, but actually, usually in the investigator who appreciates all implications of the procedure, he responsible for writing the SOP, knows how to write the SOP. It's not about what is the SOP, but there's also a regulation of how to write the SOP. SOP, it's not only made by the investigator or someone else, but it should also be reviewed and then should be approved before it is used for the study. So the reviewer usually is individuals that not make the original SOP. It can be one person or more persons, but should be someone else that also have knowledge or skills in that procedure. And then after it is reviewed, then it should be approved by the principal investigator or the authorized designee, and the investigator should sign the approval of SOP and also dated it. This is the classical format of SOP, so it should contain the title, authors, the date of authorization, the version, because usually it will be a review and then there will be a revision of SOP. We should mention which version is it, and then the date of revision, and then the rest is about the procedure of the activity. So we have to mention the aim, the scope, procedure, responsibility, and then applicability to other SOP, the glossary of the definition and references, attachment if necessary. I just put it here for example for you to have a description about the SOP. So this is the title of the SOP, this is the version and the date of SOP, and this is the authorization or the approval of SOP, and then the rest of that will be in the aim, objective, scope, procedure, etc. Next is about the writing SOP. As we need a clear instruction and detailed instruction of SOP, so we have to write it in manner and language that is appropriate to the personnel that conducting the study. If you have a multi-center study in the international collaboration, so you should translate the SOP that's already been made by the principal investigator or from the center of the study to your site. And then use action verb. Do not use a passive verb. Get directly to the point, not too long sentences. And then should be complete, containing all the necessary information. You already have the experience. What's happened if the SOP is not complete? And then you also mentioned about the objective. It should also be coherent, showing a logical thought process and sequential listing of all the steps. And it's better to put it in a bullet or numbering of the procedure, not in just a long sentence or a newspaper type of document. if necessary, we support with pictures, flow diagrams, and example of calculation. So, in summary, the SOP should be KISS. What is KISS? With 2S. F2S, keep it short and simple. F3S, keep it short and simple, stupid. No. So yeah, keep it short and simple, yeah. Well, so this is the writing of SOP. We have example here. If you write down the instruction like the first sentence, the volume of diluent should be recorded in the nurse chart. Which one is more clear? Just directly mention, record the volume of diluent in the nurse chart. Okay, so it's different. Maybe in scientific writing, sometimes we are asked to write it in a passive verb, but in SOP, we should use the active. The level of detail is also depends on the level of the expertise that the individual will perform this work. For example, if you give instruction to the doctor, maybe it's not so that detailed if you give instruction to the nurse. Or if it is done by the student, maybe it's different if it is done by the assistant professor, for example. And then use the generic name where possible, and then avoid of doing this or alternatively doing that. So we have to be clear for the SOP. Also, where appropriate, where necessary, no. So everybody will have different consideration. In SOP, we have to be strict of what they have to do with this procedure. And next, what you shouldn't forget about the SOP. So SOP is not only made for fulfilling the criteria of GCP, but we have to do our study based on the SOP. So that's where we also have to train our staff of this SOP. And then every study nurse or research assistant have to have access to the appropriate SOP. They have to comply with the instruction given in the SOP. And also, if there is deviation from SOP, they have to document and discuss with the PI or the authorized designee. And last, before we will have activity about SOP, so this is SOP should have. It should document the study method effectively and efficiently. It is support the quality of management and also support the staff training programs. And SOP should not be only document that exists only because of the regulation. This is actually what happens in developing countries when you have accreditation that need documents, so you will make so many SOP. But it's not been done or implemented daily, not trained even. And then in the next 5 years, in the next accreditation, the SOP already, we don't know where is it, and then we make it again. So that's what I mentioned in the morning, that actually from the GCP, the principle of GCP, we make SOP, we also make SOP in our institution and train it to our staff and then implement it. Okay, next, before we have a practical session about SOP, do you have any question? If no, maybe we can discuss later. So I will divide the group into two, like this group one and group two, and then you will ask to make SOP. The first group will be make a SOP of making a juice, and then group two SOP of making coffee. And then you make SOP, and then you give your XOP group one to group two, and group two to group one. Let's see whether you can make the fruit juice from the instruction of group one and whether your coffee will be as what expected by group two. Okay? Okay. Oh yeah. Okay, that's the outcome that the outcome that we want to have. Yeah. Okay, this is the group one, two, and this is group one. Group one is for the juice, and this one is.
All of them juices in one. I think you can split them into two further groups.
Mm-hmm.
First.
Diperhatikan dulu.
Connect to the.
Yeah. System. Nanti. SOP nulisnya nanti, bukan sekarang.
Kita melihat dulu.
Anda melihat demonstrasi dulu.
Oh, iya, lalu ininya alatnya di situ.
Ya.
Siapkan alat.
Jangan siapkan alat itu kan. Lihat aja dulu mbaknya ngerjain. Lihat dulu mbaknya ngerjain bagaimana, baru ditulis.
Video kayak spoon, potong apel.
Cuci dulu kan
ya. Nah itu dia. Belum cuci dulu. Potong empat,
salah.
Kupas.
Kuncinya gimana caranya?
Angkat dulu.
Masukin, tekan. Tekan.
Cut both pieces of the apple pieces.
He wear the gloves.
So, oh, okay. Yeah. He should write to focus on it.
Do it. Me, coffee machine, coffee, water.
Coffee preparation, coffee
maker. We need to write
the theory. So that they can
There should be one machine.
They can do it. Then who is going to do this? Who is going to do this?
Drinking that.
Use rubber gloves on both hands.
They already start confusing it.
Vertically, you know, four pieces.
Vertically.
And according to
okay, done. Then
cut
both the
tip of the piece.
Each piece.
Sampai memenuhi setengah kontainer.
Oke, sudah.
Kemudian
switch on the machine by pressing out.
Ada.
Oke, ada.
Nah, tunggu sampai mesinnya siap untuk digunakan. Sudah ready belum?
Ready for use.
Oke, udah itu tempatkan gelas
cangkir kopi, Pak.
Cangkir kopi.
Sudah ada kopinya,
Pak.
Cangkir kopi.
Oke.
Okay. Cangkir gelas.
Pakai tangan ya?
Tekanlah tombolnya. Menurut pemilihan Anda, sekarang mau apa? Mau espresso, mau regular atau mau cappuccino? Terus tekan E, kalau regular tekan R, pencet tekan cappuccino.
Tunggu aja.
Terus? Habis itu.
Udah.
Cuma sampai situ doang nih.
Ini campur gula atau gula sendok enggak?
Tidak, stop. Iya. Yeah. It's going to fly up.
Oh yeah.
So, yeah.
At first it should be press the cap and turn on the juicer.
So it should actually say put it in. Yeah, okay. Now.
While the machine.
Just check. Why not working?
Do be careful. Nothing should fly on top. My God.
Wait.
Yeah.
Then
okay.
Turn on the juicer.
Yes. Yes. Say give enough pressure.
Let
the whole thing.
Yeah, when to stop was not clear. When to stop.
Not even one drop for it.
Do it with how you boil.
Wait. What does it say? How will pour juices open? How will open these?
How do you boil it?
How do you pour? Good one. How to open? How will open
this? How
to pour that juice? Okay, hands of the.
Unlock the juice.
Hands of the.
Unlock the juice.
What are all the deficiencies that you
tell but simple for the maybe from this group, the coffee maker group, you will mention about the deficiencies of the SOP that already been made by the juice group. Yeah, please. So what you confused about?
So while preparing an apple juice, we faced some problems. The problems were, first, it was not mentioned how to remove the seeds. Should you remove the seeds, just only the seeds, or we should cut the end, total end? It was not clear. And then also, no clear instruction about site identification. How should we identify the site, and how to log the sites? There was no clear identification. And then, how to replace the cap, and how to turn the juicer? This is also not mentioned. And regarding the tip, what do you mean by tip? Tip is also not clear, because it could be also the middle portion or the upside portion. Yeah. So, and how long it should be pressed? Like the time also not mentioned, and the amount of pressure. Should we press lightly or press hard? It is not also not mentioned. Yeah, because we face problem, because first we pressed it lightly and nothing happened. And how to pour the juice? After preparation, should we, we are very confused how to pour. Should we remove the lower portion or, yeah. So that was very confusing. And also how to unlock the juicer after completion? How should we unlock the juicer? That was not mentioned. And finally, what type of glass should we use to pour the juice? Is it clean glass or dirty glass? Not mentioned.
Okay, and the other thing is when you have to turn on the juicer, so you don't mention that we have to close. Yeah. I also like to comment number two, the instruction number two, so use rubber gloves on both hands. Any comment? So we have to make a clear and detailed instruction, but it's not necessary to mention that you put your gloves on your both hands, because we will not put it in the food. Yeah. So it's already clear that the gloves is on the hands, not just put it in one hand. No. Yeah. Oh, okay. So
the gloves.
Oh, okay. That's glove or gloves. Glove or gloves. If gloves means it's more than one. Yeah. Remove the, cut the both tip of each piece. So they means at the end of the the pieces, but tip of the piece is, it's a bit confusing in English. They're English. This is the Indonesian English, is different. Okay, next, the tweezer group, you comment for the coffee maker.
Such a sharp knife. I was so much worried that she might hurt herself. So you must clearly give instructions to say, while de-seeding, use the knife in the opposite direction, the sharpness of the knife, right? That's something that you need to mention. Same way as Nina mentioned, if you don't cap the thing and you turn on the machine, the apple will fly up. And that's very dangerous, right? So these are kind of tips and safety measures that are really very, very crucial, right? If you miss it, of course they bypassed all that and they did that, but you got to be extremely careful. Okay, just wanted to make those two safety tips. Yeah.
Go ahead. Previously, we confused which one we should use, this one or this one, because there is two instructions here. And then after we read this one and this one, we choose the instruction from this small paper. We found a picture here, and then we try to follow the instruction, wash our hand, and then wearing gloves. There's no water there. And then wear gloves. Where we have to use the gloves? In our hand or in our foot? One hand or two hands? And then preheat the machine 15 till 20 minutes. Luckily, the machine already plugged onto the electric. How about the machine not yet plugged to electric? Maybe we will wait for a long time because the machine still not on position. And then give 3 handful coffee bean on right side of the container. Okay, we look to the picture and we look and we find the container here, coffee beans container and water container. Luckily for you, because the water container already full with water and the coffee container already coffee bean inside. But if there is no coffee inside and there is no water at the other side of container, so which one we will put it the coffee? Container. Which one container? The water container or the coffee bean container? It's not clear. And then you said put water on left side container. That's the next step. After we confuse, then we found the answer. And then you said there are 3 buttons: espresso, regular, and cappuccino. Actually, there is 6 buttons there. And then we look into the picture. Okay. But actually 6 buttons there. Yeah, 6 buttons, not 3 buttons. We try to push 1 button. And then the coffee out. The machine already on position, so it press espresso and the cappuccino and the coffee out. But some of us tell if we make a cappuccino, we should add milk to make a special taste of cappuccino. But you didn't give information to us whether we have to add milk or not to make cappuccino. That's all, I think, from us.
There are different kind of coffee. Espresso, the black coffee, but regular, maybe the concentrated light coffee. So, the title make a coffee, but the kind of coffee, we don't know. Thank you.
Instruction, even though we just mentioned about how to make a cup of coffee, actually it should be the title making a cup of coffee, because the man there, the end of the result is a cup of coffee, and they give sugar also in the plate. Yeah, so you are not sound that complete. Yeah, but then even though it's we have option there about espresso, regular, and cappuccino coffee, you can make a general SOP, but then if you want to make it, then press this one. If you want to make it, just give or add the milk, etc. Okay? Or the other option is you make it one by one, how to make a cup of coffee, cappuccino, a cup of coffee of espresso, or the regular one. Okay, I think we have to applause for all of us. Yeah. And then that's the end of the SOP. Do you have any questions for all of the session? Maybe you still have questions about the ethics, about the essential data, and also the principle of GCP. We can still have 5 minutes. No?
Or we can take a picture together.
Okay, then. It's more interesting. Okay, thank you.
Remember our ground rule, that we have to be on time. we will have a quick recapitulation of what we learned today, and then we will go ahead to tomorrow's session. 8:30, we meet tomorrow. Okay?
Tomorrow will be long day.